My name is Tycho and this is my YouTube channel about Amsterdam. In this video, I'm gonna be talking about a book, Stuff Dutch People Like. I am Dutch and I'm gonna see if I agree with the stuff which is in this book or disagree. Let's go. Number 26, windmills. Yeah, well, that's typical Dutch, right? Why is it number 26? Why is it so far in the book? I wonder why. Yesterday you taught me about a blue sky and all that I could see was just a yellow lemon tree. There's a nice town close to Amsterdam called Zaandam or the Zaanse Schans, and there's loads of windmills to be seen there. There's also a couple in Amsterdam, but that's really the place where they're all stacked up. I see there are around 1,000 windmills left in the whole country. All right. Number 27, picking their noses. This is our king right now. I think at the time of this book, it wasn't. Maybe it was just an itchy nose, you know, like. I can't say anything about this. I never pick my nose. Number 28, fries and mayo. I just gotta say, it's not the same mayonnaise that you got in America. From Hellman or Hellsman. It tastes totally different. Last time I wanted to order mayonnaise again, it was sold out, the one I always take. So I got this jar of Hellman or Hellsman. That's not for fries. It's so difficult to eat my fries with that. I had real trouble to finish my plate. But yes, fully agree with this. We love fries with mayonnaise. Number 29, licorice. Yes, I love it. And I know that almost none of the tourists, I think 99% of the people I've hosted here, no one likes licorice. And so I love giving it to them, you know? Like, here, try out this real Dutch candy. I don't know if it's real Dutch, but at least we love it. I think it's also in the UK. You can buy them salty or sweet, honey flavor. I could eat this till I feel sick. Not a good thing, actually, is it? Oh, number 30. Forcing drop on unsuspecting foreigners. Well, that's funny because I just now said it at number 29, right? What are the chances? Probably every Dutch person will read this book and comes at 29, like, yeah, I like to give it to foreigners. And then number 30, there you go. Well, this is the face that they make. I just proved, you know, that is something Dutch people like. Yeah, number 31. Keeping it real. Keeping it real, all right. Yeah. The Dutch are allergic to the American good morning, how y'all doing lingo. They shudder when entering an American store, only to be greeted by those five annoying little words. How are you doing today? It's a fairly innocent question for North Americans or Brits, but for the Dutch, it's downright scandalous. Why are they asking? Why do they care? They don't even want my answer. It has happened a lot of times that people ask me that question and I will tell them how I'm doing. If I'm doing good, I'll tell them why I'm doing good. And if I'm doing bad, I'll tell them I slept bad because I was hunting mosquitoes down all night long. Then I woke up, I dropped my coffee, this, that, bloody, bloody, blah. I'll tell them everything. And that's the way the cookie crumbles. Names that sound ridiculous in English. I think every language has its names, right? Which are unpronounceable or sound strange. Number 33, well, I talked about this already, King's Day. Let's just show you this photo, because that's a typical scene on King's Day. So all the country will be like this. Number 34, dat kan niet. I don't know, dat kan niet. Is that something we say a lot? Dat kan niet. Number 35, impossible steep stairs. My stairs are quite okay. I remember I once had a friend and he lived in an older building. And yeah, it was quite steep, especially on the way down. It's quite tricky, you know, you really walk on your heels or a little bit sidewards. Number 36, Sinterklaas. Okay, well, this is quick. This is the guy I was talking about. This is Sinterklaas sitting on his horse. And this is his helper. Black Pete. I talked enough about that, I think. Number 37, a birthday calendar. I got something like this on the toilet as well. That's pretty handy because you're always in the toilet. Oh, not always, but you're there every day normally, I think. And you see the names like, oh, it's Jonathan's birthday next week. Oh, we don't need Facebook with their notifications. We just have a birthday calendar. But none of my friends has a birthday calendar. Oh, no, wait. Just one of my friends has a birthday calendar. I should just give a birthday calendar to all my friends and write down my own birthday in there. Yeah, I should write down my birthday, other celebration days for Tycho, the day that I started my YouTube channel, you know, so they can really think of me. Yeah, that's a good idea. Not working slash working. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, but Dutch people like to work and to not work. Ah, they're the best in the European Union at not working. Well, I think with the corona, of course, things changed, that everyone got as good as the Dutch at not working. Oh yeah, of course, I enjoy not working. If I don't work, I'm enjoying that. But you just gotta enjoy every moment. If you work, you enjoy your work. If you don't work, you enjoy that you don't work. Simple as that. Cows that say boo. Cows in Holland say boo instead of moo. So yeah, if there comes a cow from Texas to the Netherlands, they'll not be able to communicate. But isn't it like every language? In Japan, the animals also make different sounds. Tiny sinks with only cold water. Usually in the toilet, there's a tiny sink with cold water to wash your hands. It's very easy, you just... I have never noticed in other countries that I missed a tiny sink. Or that I thought, oh, what, the sink is pretty big in here. Number 41, being tall. I am 1 meter 95 centimeters, so yeah, I approve of this. Do we like it? It's just a fact. Because of all the milk, right? All the milk and all the cheese. Swearing with diseases. Yes, 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 yes. It became somehow, you know, normal in the language to shout with diseases like the plague, the cholera, tuberculosis, cancer. Of course, the Dutch also shout with normal things, but let's just keep the video a bit nice for now, or just, not just for now, but just till the end of the video. Let's just keep the video a bit nice. Anyways, yes, this happens. I don't like it when people shout with diseases. I think it's weak. Number 43, speaking in expressions. I don't know if you saw that, they're out of the sleeve. That's a proverb, and I love proverbs and expressions, and my mother as well. She's always speaking with expressions and proverbs, and I approve of this again. I agree. That's something Dutch people like. White leggings. Just one of my exes had white leggings, so it's not so, I don't think it's that common actually. No. No. I really thought about it and I think... No. Beschuit met muisjes. Yeah, if there's a baby born, it's a tradition. Here on the photo. This is for a girl. And for a boy, it would be white with light blue. You give it to the people in your baby shower or something, right? Yeah, I remember at elementary school, if there was a little baby born from someone in the class, I mean like a little brother or sister from some child in the class, then he or she would also come with, you know, beschuit with muisjes. Muisjes, little mice. And that's really the only occasion you eat them, actually. They're quite hard also. It's not like this. Suspicious spreads. That's a tongue breaker. These spreads in the supermarket. Isn't that everywhere in the world? People, can you let me know in the comment section, please? Yeah. Egg salad or crab salad or chicken curry salad. I can talk about this. I don't buy so many spreads. Number 47, do normaal or act normal. Like me, bragging, showing off, discussing money, not following every important or written rules and regulations. Etc. etc. And then a Dutch person would say to you, do normaal. I think people are saying that to me quite often, do normaal, when I'm, I don't know, making loud sounds or singing a song or something like that. People are a little bit ashamed maybe. Tycho, do normaal, do normaal. And then I have to act normal again. Yeah? Like, oh, put on my mask and act normal. And I'm not talking about my face mask. Number 48, delaying marriage. I'm not gonna talk about this right now. I'm gonna delay it. Number 49, infiltrating English. Dutch people should be proud, very proud. For such a tiny little country, they managed to successfully penetrate the English language. Dutch bargain, Dutch defense, Dutch courage, Dutch gold, going Dutch, Dutch widow. I can't say anything useful about this, sorry, because I'm Dutch. I guess if you're from the UK or the US or Australia, maybe, that you might, you know, think like, oh yeah, oh yeah, that's true, very, very, very true. And last, and maybe even least, I don't know, number 50. Oh. Number 50, that is, so that's nothing. It says, do you have the missing stuff Dutch people like item to complete our list? And then on the other side, it has a few choices. Oh, this is the top 10 stuff Dutch people don't like. Being mistaken for German, yes. I remember like last month or something, someone thought Amsterdam was in Germany. Alright guys, that's it for this video. So this book is written by Colleen Geske. Yeah, it's a pretty cool book. It was quite fun to review this book. I think I'm gonna give it 5 out of 5 stars. As I said, there's a link in the description below if you want to check the current price of this book. And thank you for watching. And till this day, now we celebrate 3 days earlier because our current king is... His birthday is on the 27th of April. And... Okay. Cut this out. Cut this out, Tycho. You don't need this. And it says King's Day. But that's strange. You know why it's strange? Because it only became King's Day since he became the king. And before that it was Queen's Day. And this book is printed in 2013. But... Let me just check it. If he was the king already in 2013. I think it was later. Aha, see? So since 2014, it's King's Day. So, yeah, the book comes from 2013, but they made some change then. Or when she made the book, she already knew. It was maybe after she made it, like after the last Queen's Day. And then she knew the next one was going to be King's Day. So I guess that's it. Yeah, I solved it.